Hachette Audio presents Wise Up, Irreverent Enlightenment from a Mother Who's Been Through It. Written and read by Karen Duffy and Francis Gasparini. To John Fortune Lambros and Jack Augustine Lambros. There is not a particle of my love that is not yours. James Joyce. Introduction. Dear listener, when you're browsing audiobooks, it's not easy to decide which program to blow your hard-earned cash on. Some people just read the blurb and check out the zinger reviews. I assure you that if you take a moment to listen, I will persuade you that this audiobook is worth every penny of your investment. Ignore your buzzing phone and keep listening. You come from a long line of survivors. You are the latest link in an unbroken chain of ancestors. The Latin root for survive is supervivere, meaning to live beyond, live longer, and continue in existence after the death of another. You are the descendant of people who lived through natural and man-made disasters, wars, pandemics, and cataclysms of all kind. They endured pain, grief, fear, and loss. They outlasted quarantines. This is your genetic inheritance. You are humanity's greatest upgrade. You are a miracle, a wonder. You are 40 trillion cells thrumming with life force. There is an original, radiant, and unrepeatable brilliance within you. This is the raw material from which we shape our lives. Now that we can agree that you are alive, can we also agree that you have many big questions? Why were you born? How can you be a good person? How many cannibals would your body feed? And of course, how shall you live? Will the course of your life be determined by drift or by decision? Don't we owe it to our intrepid ancestors to do our best to live a good life of meaning and purpose? Imagine you could watch a film of your life, from birth to death. What would it take for you to jump out of your chair, start pumping your fists in the air, and shout, "Yes, this is it. This is a good life. This is a life well lived." How do you live a good life? By defining a philosophy for living. A philosophy is nothing more than some simple rules for yourself. If you have a grasp on how the world works and have a sense on how to behave towards others, you have a philosophy of life. It is a framework, a backbone, a set of principles or guidelines that give your life direction and prevent drift. It is never too late to get smarter or be better. Whether you just came out of a coma, emerged from self-isolation, or are just surfing around the internet looking for an audiobook, you are blessed with life, and you are one of the luckiest people to have ever drawn a breath. It is up to you to make the most of your time here. We say you only live once, but truthfully, you live every day. You only die once. Every day is an opportunity to examine your life, to be inspired, to take small actions and make improvements and corrections that will steer you toward the goal of being a good person. My life has been greatly enhanced by applying the principles of Stoic wisdom. The simplicity of the philosopher Epictetus's quote, "If you make beautiful choices, so too will you be," reverberated through me like a firecracker in a cymbal factory. I have distilled the practical wisdom of the Stoics into a book of breezy letters to my son. I do some of my best communicating in letters, and I hope to set off an explosion in you, too. If your ultimate goal is to stand up and cheer for your life, the journey begins with the philosophy. Life doesn't give you a manual, but it does give you a mother. Thanks for listening this far. Sincerely, the author. Chapter 1. Why I Write You Letters. Dear Jack, I'm writing to you from a body that once carried the promise of yours. Now when I embrace you, it feels like I'm hugging a bicycle, all muscle and bone, sinew and angles, the sharp blades of your shoulders, the stony protuberances of your elbows, the xylophone of ribs, and the knots of spine are so far from the soft squish of the 10-pound newborn that cannonballed out of the business end of the birth canal. You are my only son, and your life has been a rush of moments. From meeting you as you inhaled for the first time as an air-breathing mammal, to applauding as you took your first steps as a toddler, then racing behind you as you scooted to preschool, and cheering you as you skated towards the peewee hockey team, where you found your people and your place in the world. Now you're expanding from boy to adolescent, to late teen, to early adult. I carried you in my arms, and one day you outgrew this, and I set you down, and I never, ever picked you up again. Later on, I looked up the saddest things in the world, and this was at the top of the list. The one consolidative experience shared by the entirety of human life is the months-long gestation, folded up like a tiny lawn chair, inside a woman's body. You existed in me, and at your birth, you began your life, and I began a new life as well, one in which your well-being is always within the dominion of my consciousness. To parent is to become inextricably snared in the conflict of cheering on your independence and worrying about your self-sovereignty. Puberty is an origin story. The ability to transform from child to full-grown human is a superpower. Your body is shape-shifting, and every sense is affected. Your taste in food, the music you listen to, and what you read have all evolved. Your ravenous appetite is fueling your growth. You are stronger and hairier, a human crop sprayer of bio. You see your peers and your romantic partners through a new lens. You now possess the terrifying power to contribute to the creation of another human being with the cells of your body. Yes, your body is a temple, but after crew practice, it is less a house of worship and more like a Coachella festival for bacteria. I witnessed your growth and transition from baby to boy to man. These stages of development progressed with breathless agility. I missed the big, bald, melon-headed Jack the Lad with the gap-toothed smile. Well, you do play hockey, so maybe I'll see that toothless grin again. How many more times will I remember that when you wanted to be freed from your crib, you would call me sweetheart, darling, or beauty, the names you heard your father call me when he wanted my attention? How many more times will I tell that story about your kindergarten class calendar, when you drew a naked picture of me in the bathtub reading a book? It was mostly a stick figure, but you went anatomically and hirsutely accurate and drew a lady bush that looked like a raccoon was sitting on my lap, taking a bath with me. That calendar page, which was displayed during the longest month of October, earned me the nickname Crockett from the wise-ass moms at your elementary school. How many more times will I have to answer to that sobriquet? On reflection, I do hope that that part of my life is ended. As one of my favorite writers, Paul Bowles, wrote in The Sheltering Sky, how many more times will you remember a certain afternoon of your childhood? Some afternoon that's so deeply a part of your being that you can't even conceive of your life without it. Perhaps 4 or 5 more times. Perhaps not even that. How many times will you watch the full moon rise? Perhaps 20, yet it all seems limitless. There is a built-in obsolescence to the parent-child relationship. Your childhood seemed boundless, and now you are on the precipice of adulthood. To see the gentleman you have grown into is the greatest happiness of my life. I recognize that I'm no longer the son you once revolved around. You have spun off to create your new life in a new orbit. My job was to raise an independent progeny. Your job is to be independent. We each have done our jobs. Well done, both of us. When you were younger, I attempted to explain the physiobiology of your maturation. One of the chemicals swimming in your cojones is the hormone testosterone. This powerful secretion kicks in to customize your face with zits and whiskers and grow muscles and hair. It
synthesizes. We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.